Today I want to speak to us from the book of Psalms, chapter 46 and verse 1 to 5. And it says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear though the earth be moved, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof. There is a river, the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. And there is the key verse, God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. Reading from the King James Version. I want to acknowledge the presence of the Holy Ghost in our midst this morning, because we all came armed with the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Father, in the name of Jesus, I present us before you right now, God. I come, Lord, with arms stretched out, with arms raised, hands raised to you, O God, waiting to receive from you, God. I am but a vessel, Lord. Use me for your service. Lord, the ears that are gathered here today, let them hear directly from you, God. The hearts that are turned up, O God, let them receive of your word. Lord, let everyone who is here, Lord, be touched in a special way, the way that you desire, the way that you require. Hallelujah. And let us all at the end of this, oh God, be rejoicing, ready to give you all the glory and all the honor that is to your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Hallelujah. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. I dare to tell you this morning, good things happens in the morning. You see, what the verse of 5 is telling us, that verse, that phrase, and that right early, that phrase is a word that means boker, B-O-Q-E-R. And that word means the period of time before noon. Or, you know, the night is divided into 3 watches. And this is the last watch. This is the morning watch. It comes somewhere between 2 a.m. and the sunrise. And the word is telling us that even though we are going through an earthquake, even though our world is getting torn upside down and our mountains get thrown into the sea, even though the waters in our life is raging, God is in the midst of it. And before the sun rises, before the crack of dawn, God is going to help you. God is going to help me. Hallelujah. God is in the midst of it. God is in the midst of her. We will not be moved when God is in the midst of us. God is going to always help us, and he's always going to be early. You see, what is God doing if he is going to be helping us before morning? It means that God was taking care of it at night. It means when you and I were asleep, God was taking care of your situation. When that mountain was being moved, when that sea was raging, God was taking care of it. So that before dawn, at the crack of dawn, when you and I awake, God has already helped us. That's what the verse is saying. Take it in. God is in the midst of us. Though the earth be removed, though the mountains be cast into the sea, God will help her, and he'll do it early. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I have a question for you. What are you doing during the night hours? Are you up conscious when you sleep? Most of us are sleeping at night. We know that there are some people who are up, but the night hours was made for sleep. So let's go with the thought that we are sleeping at night. And while you're sleeping, are you conscious of what's happening next door? Are you able to make your heart beat? Are you able to keep your temperature up? Are you able to keep the breath in your lungs? When you are asleep, and you can't do that when you're awake either, do you have time to make plans? When you are asleep, you are in an unconscious state, yes? But you see, when you are asleep, God is taking care of your situation. You see, that's what God is doing at night. Let me give you some examples. Exodus chapter 10 and verse 13. It says that Moses stretched forth his rod over the land of Egypt, and the Lord brought an east wind upon the land all that day and all that night. And what happened? And when it was morning, hallelujah, and when it was morning, the east wind brought the locusts. And if you need a context to what this is about, this is the children of Israel that God has decided he is going to save from slavery. He has sent Moses down to Egypt, and he is sending plagues upon Pharaoh so that the children of Israel could be set free. And this is the eighth plague. In the morning is when the locusts came. But what was happening at night? God was causing that east wind to gather all of the locusts that he wants to throw upon Egypt. Because in the morning, they're going to be hit by it. What is God doing at night? God is taking care of your mountain and my mountain. Hallelujah. That is what God is doing at night. So if you're doing what you're supposed to do at night, which is sleep, God is going to handle your business. Because at that right early, at the crack of dawn, God is helping. Hallelujah. And example number two. And we find that example still in Exodus chapter 14 and verse 24 to 30. And it came to pass that in the morning watch, I'm reading King James Version, the Lord looked upon the host of the Egyptians through the pillar of fire and of cloud, and troubled the host of the Egyptians. Listen to what God is doing at night. And he took off the chariot's wheels. Did you know that? He took off the chariot's wheels. So the Egyptians are headed, they've let the Israelites go, but they had a change of heart. So now they're chasing after them to take them back. But God stood in the way. Hallelujah. God is taking care of things when you and I are asleep. He took off the chariot wheels, and they drove heavily, so that the Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the face of Israel, for the Lord fighteth for them against Egypt." You know, the enemy will know that when God comes in to save his children, they will know it is the hand of God doing it for you. They will recognize the power of God when God is helping at night. So here they're saying, let us take off, let us go, because God is fighting for Israel. And the Lord said unto Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea, that the waters may come again upon the Egyptians, and upon their chariots, and upon their horsemen. And Moses stretched forth his hand over the sea, and the sea returned to its strength when the morning appeared. Hallelujah. When the morning appeared. And I'll skip to verse 27. I am in verse 27. And the Egyptians fled against it, and the Lord overthrew the Egyptians in the midst of the sea. You see, 30 says the Lord saved Israel that day. What is God doing at night when you and I are supposed to be asleep? God is taking care of your business and my business. The word of God says everything that concerneth you and me, he perfects it. Hallelujah. So when you are asleep, God is dismantling the workings of the enemy. When you and I are asleep, God is taking apart, you know, he is interrupting the agenda of the enemy. You know, when you and I are asleep, it's equal to trusting God. Because when you are asleep, you don't know what's going on. You have complete confidence. that you can lay in peace when you trust God, the same way that you know nothing when you are asleep. And if you allow God, if you trust God in that regard, if you allow God to do what he does for us when we are asleep, when we trust him, God is taking care of the things that concerns you and the things that concerns me. I have another example, and I want to take that example from the book of 2 Kings chapter 19, verse 32 to 35. Therefore, thus saith the Lord concerning the king of Assyria, he shall not come into this city. He shall not shoot an arrow there. He shall not come before it with a shield, nor cast a bank against it. The way that he came, that same way he shall return. And he shall not come into that city. And that city we're talking about is the city of Israel, the city of Jerusalem. And it shall come to pass that night, verse 34, and I will defend the city to save it for mine own sake and for my servant David's sake. You see, when you have favor with God, God is going to step into your situation. When you have favor with God, God is going to say, that thing that is coming towards you shall not touch you. That thing that the enemy is planning, the same way he's coming, he's going to go back. You shall not enter into this place. That house that you have sanctified, Sister Angela, you're talking about you have grown up kids. That house that you have sanctified, the Lord said he is going to defend it. Verse 34, he will defend that city. You know why? And it shall come to pass that night that the angel of the Lord went out. What is God doing that night? And smote the camp of the Assyrians 185,000. And when you wake up in the morning, hallelujah, when they arose early in the morning, I told you at the crack of dawn, somewhere between 2 a.m. and sunrise, God is going to help you. When they rose up early in the morning, behold, all their enemies were dead. You know, the king of Assyria had the audacity to surround Jerusalem, saying he's going to take them. He's going to destroy them. And God said, not so. No, sir. I will defend the city. They will not come near it. They're not going to shoot an arrow towards it. This is what the Lord is saying in our situation. When the enemy says, I am coming for you, God is going to say, not today. I will defend my child. I will stand up for my child. What is God doing at night? He is destroying the camp of the enemy, 185,000 of them, while they slept. While you and I are sleeping, God is handling our business. So if we trust God, I just told you, trusting is like sleeping. If you think about what you do when you sleep, nothing. You don't even know if you're breathing. You don't know what's going on next door. You don't have time to be bothersome. I know some of us have restless nights, but when we trust God, we can go to sleep because we know that at night, God is taking care of the things that concerns us. Lamentations 3 and 22 and 23 reminds us that the Lord's mercy, it is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed. Because his compassion fails not. God is always taking care of us. And his compassion is new every morning. Because God is faithful that every single solitary morning, he pours compassion out to you and to me. His compassion fails not. God is faithful, brethren. God is faithful, children of God. You know that at night when you're asleep, when you wake up, you have a fresh dose of mercy. You have a fresh dose of compassion sent to you. You see, God takes care of things at night, Think of the children of Israel when they cried for food. He told Moses that in the morning they will have manna fresh every morning. When you are asleep, if you allow God, if you trust God so that you can go to sleep, God is going to take care of the things that you are crying about. That mountain that's running into the sea, that earthquake that's happening in your life, that disruption that's in your path, God is going to dismantle it. God is going to interrupt it. God is going to throw a wrench in that plan. No matter what the things are, when you are asleep, God takes care of it. He said he will help you, and that right early. He will help you before the crack of dawn. He will help you before the morning breaks. You know, there's a song that says that he showed up 4 days late, but he was still on time. God is always on time. God is always on time. And Psalms is telling us he is early. He is early. When you go to close your eyes and you wake up the next day, God is there. You know, so no matter what is going on, while you sleep, God works. And if you're sleeping like trusting, you wake up in the morning and you find that God has taken care of your situation. Because there's a psalm that says, as I close, weeping may endure for the night. You might be going through that situation through the night, but joy cometh in the morning. And joy comes in the form of praise, because he's given us joy as a garment of praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So I leave with you that good things happens in the morning. If you let God, if you and I let God, because this word is as much for me as it is for you. If we let God handle the business of our lives at night, whatever that night signifies in your life, in your darkest hour, because 2 a.m. to the sunrise, in that moment when you by yourself laying on your bed and you think that you're the only one who knows what you're going through, God is going to help, and he's going to do it that right early. Hallelujah. I leave those words with you, that the Lord blesses your heart. Father God, in the name of Jesus, your son, I want to thank you, O God, for your words. I want to thank you, O God, for giving meaning, hallelujah, to the word, hallelujah, so that someone, somewhere could know that, Lord, you are present in their situation. And not only present, God, but you are early. Lord, I pray that you bless every heart, that the word that was received be watered, be maintained, be nourished, that it feeds them not just for today, but for in time and time again. When they run into those mountains, they will know that you are present help in trouble, in times of trouble. In Jesus' name I pray. Hallelujah.